I got cut off in the middle of the sentence, so I guess we'll film another one real quick, or partial one or something. So, should already have more of these things in that trailer, so we'll at least finish this lap and go sell that. Maybe I'll record the video that stop this part two then, and continue on. Or continue on, I mean. Because even this isn't all going to fit in that trailer. But it might be too tall. Let's see. And it does that too all the time. It like pops up saying the helper completed their task. Who the hell are they talking about? Nobody's hired. I think that might be just a glitch or something, but it does that on all the maps. It's not just this map or something like that. And but I'll probably, where's the wages? I'll probably say I paid someone like $6. You know, $1. I paid no one to do nothing yet. So dump this trailer, should be full. We'll go sell this or see if we can figure out where we went last time. I might end up at the end of the video there, because I at least gotta get up to, I should have beat 7. I don't know why my audio keeps on making noise. Yep, still got 1,000 pounds left. That's pretty good though. And another plus if you're farming is it gives you a visual representation on their little map. What's done with the field and what isn't. And it's a lot easier to tell. Oops, wrong button. What the hell? That should have turned off the thing. That's why I said it. Aha. Anyway. So yeah, there's a visual representation on the map of what's done on the field and everything, so it's easier to tell what spots you missed and stuff. Alright, so I think we're going down to Empire Stores, one of those places, so yeah. Should have to turn right on the road, and then there is a field you can cut through. But we have barley, so let's see here. Yeah, Empire Stores is the... one at this point. I sold all the duplicates of all the equipment and everything that I had that they give you, and then kept the other stuff. So far I'm only on day one. I only played it for a couple hours, but we don't need to go stats to bore you with that. So we'll drive this over to the that place and sell it and head back. Like, this track is pretty cool. I think this is one of them, like, well, obviously the dash works, but I think on there, like, yeah, like, I can see in up towards the right little tiny letters. I think it's showing your speed and RPMs, but I thought one harvester I drove actually did show you. There was one spot that showed the capacity in the harvester. So, hopefully we can figure where we're going. Like I said, these are all real tight maps, so may or may not end up using the equipment I have, and see how this works. I haven't really watched any yet. Probably should, but watched bits and pieces of much other videos on YouTube on this game, but there's a couple YouTubers that are got some good videos, but haven't watched them or in their entirety or whatever, and maybe tried to stay away from some of them so I experienced it myself. Yeah, see, this thing's kind of struggling. It's a pretty big hill, it must be. This thing's struggling. And like I said, hopefully I can figure out where the hell I cut through. Because you kind of can cut down, because otherwise this street dead ends. It doesn't go in a loop like you think it would or should to drive around to the place. You have to, it's like a dirt road I gotta get to that goes along all the fields. Can't remember if this one's, yeah, I think this one's it, but you gotta make sure you go the right way. One of the ways doesn't work, you get trapped in the fields. What the hell is that? Oh, that's, oh, maybe not. Did I go, what the hell is that? Is that my header trailer? Could I just, let's see, I could have just popped the other corner, maybe. Unless I'm going the wrong way. No, because that little tiny dark dash, I think, is the dirt road to go down. Maybe. I'm probably going to get lost. So, it's going to be a video of me driving my crops around trying to figure out where it's going. Or how to get down there. I think I'm pretty sure he went the wrong way. There was a way to get down and kind of connect. Yeah, let's get up. Oops, wrong button. Let's get the real map up. Like I said, it's hard to see. Where the hell am I? We need to go to Empire Store. So yeah, we definitely need to get to left and down, but yeah, we might be, you gotta cut through some hallway without getting stuck. By all those hedges up there. That just looks like there's, yeah, there's a road right there. You know? Okay, you can take that. That's not the way I want, not the way I wanted to go, but looks like you can take that road all the way down and then turn left. I was trying to, there's some way you can, up by 36 and 5, there's a good road over there somewhere you can drive through there, and I think there might be one gate, but I don't know, so I guess we're just gonna go the easy route this time and turn left and turn left again, it looks like. So, if anyone's watching out there, fail. Because there is a quicker way. There is one of these. It's a little bit bigger than this on the side of the field. There's a dirt road that goes down. And you may or may not open up one gate. You can kind of cut through. Yeah. When I first started playing this map, I forgot about it. It's based off the UK and immediately went in the wrong lane. Or correct lane. Whichever way you want. It's kind of weird. So, we're going left and left. Maybe we'll end it there, and maybe we'll have another fail and try and figure out how to get back quicker way. That's, like I said, it's gonna be kind of hard to farm this map with small roads and turns, and looks like there's only basically one entry and exit, and it's gonna be a lot of driving and use up a lot of fuel, and it's not like you can complement it by using gigantic equipment, because you won't be able to get your equipment down there. Just if you're playing it. I don't know if you can cut all that shit down. I'm trying to play as real as I can. Wait a minute. I don't think that's the way I need to go. Yeah, see? The little roads. It looks like, let's head up here now. Should be up on the left. Another steep climb that's appearing. Cruise control, that's one I gotta be careful of. Like O does everything. It activates cruise control and it'll actually hire your worker and lowers and the headers and stuff. Not too much. And if you're trying to do it on this fly. Wow, this guy's struggling. I think it said it was 145 horsepower. This is one of the tractors that comes with the game. But I was debating about whether they're selling this or not afterwards, because everything's brand new. Because this one can put a front loader attachment on it, and that will come in handy for shoveling around stuff if I don't use the Bobcat bulldozer I have on my other maps. Yeah, we still got a little ways to go. I don't know what that F is. I think that F must be some other field. Forgot. It says on the description on some of these. Barely started in the map, so I get confused. Yeah, that big F probably stands for somebody's farm. No, there's, yeah, there's an E. I think the E stands for somebody else's farm. Unless like the egg, well, maybe that's the egg cell points. That's probably the egg cell points. One reason I probably should have watched some of these other famous YouTuber videos to watch them, but. Two over here, so. Oh no, one looks like one's poo. And, do we have to back it in, or where do we sell this? Nope. Looks like there. We'll see. But, it's probably gonna be easier to back it in anyway. At least to get out. Small working area, so large equipment's gonna be hard, especially if you can't, sometimes I can do this, sometimes I can't, especially because it's just like if you're farming, the camera always keeps on screwing with you. So from what I can tell, I think I'm going that tiny little ramp. Hopefully. Yeah, that'll work, but let's get it straighter than that. We shall soon find out. It's giving me another load prompt, so my money's going up. Okay, good.
You went to the right place. Now.
$21,000, nice. That will come in handy. Stop the engine. I know, because I know there's a way that goes like kind of straight across, so I don't have to drive all the way the hell around. Where did I go? It looks like it might be down by field 49 and 5. So I'm gonna turn left out here and go down there.
Instead of driving all the way the hell around, what I do for trying to look at the map. And all these little roads through here too, it looks awesome. Especially, yeah, dude, I'll have to watch some of the videos, just especially in seasons, like, because I'm going to do the seasons and the Midwest one, probably. So all these will turn, well, I don't know, because it's UK, so I don't know what they're going to do, but these don't look like deciduous trees, so they should change colors and lose all the leaves and everything. And try and shovel this tiny little road. So we're headed up towards in between 49 and 5, it looked like. I think that's where I cut through. Yeah, because I think I remember this barn, or that little house that I drove through with the truck. Remember that car. Hopefully I'm going the right way and not just looking at a hedge as a border. It's hard to tell the difference between the hedges and the... I can't really see the dirt road. There may or may not be one gate I need to open, and then there's like a tiny little road that goes along the field. Is this it? Yeah, I think this might be it. Where am I? Yeah, because the same thing, the map ends up there. So you gotta, like, cut through in those little lines. Like, sometimes I can't tell if it's a hedge or if it's a path. Well, we'll keep recording. This will be another fail of trying to figure out how to get back. Might be the winner though. Because one way traps you in your fields and one way cuts back up to the road. Like here, I think if you go left, you get trapped down in those fields. But we're gonna find out because I'm gonna go right. I'm pretty confident with this. And then you can go along the edge of this field. That's the field I was trying to go along the edge of. Take you to the road. But it looks like you can drive straight through, but you can't. It's a big edge. So that's why this is the one that I've got to go along the edge of, and then there is another little break in the hedges or a gate or something. Worried about traffic once again. I'm gonna go back down this way and head down to my field, I think. Yep. Alright, sweet. Then I don't have to drive all the way down the main road. Basically one that goes around the perimeter, more or less. So I'll drive back to the field while in the video there, because I gotta preview my oven. I gotta get up. And wait 20 minutes or so and throw in the prime rib that I'm cooking for myself. First time, so should be an experience. Now, we parked this guy in a completely different spot now, because half the field's gone. We'll park him right up in the middle somewhere and turn him around. Hopefully next time I play this, I remember to go that direction. Maybe I'll park on the end over here, because that's the way the pipe's going to be facing, at least with this brain. And it'll clue me in to head this direction. So we'll just stop this over here somewhere. Shut him off. Get out of here, and I guess I'll conclude part two, because all the rest is going to be is harvesting the rest of this field and selling the rest of it, and then maybe part three if I continue on with this farm. Or this, I was going to do this on Lone Oak, but this was the game I was working on at the moment last night, or when I ended last night, so maybe I'll do a Let's Play on Oakfield, because it's a tiny farm, and looks really sweet, and it looks like it's going to be sweet, but hard to do, which is kind of cool. So, and I can't run, and I can't, like, go, like, out of body and see myself, but I do like that you can jump in this game, and the unrealistic part of climbing all over all that crap is I can jump up on top of this thing and see the whole field. Because I thought I usually can. There we go. Because then you can get a bird's eye view of everything. That's cool. Every game has its pluses and minuses for sure. So. Goodbye. I'll end this one, and maybe we'll do another one bailing. Because that's going to be the next thing to do, so. Hopefully we have enough money by then to, buy a trailer, and I can't remember if this is a game that I have the front loader or don't have the front loader. I'm mixing them all up, so probably need to, buy a front loader and forks of some kind. Yeah. So it looks like I need to buy, front loader, forks of some kind. I'm gonna need to, if I want hay, I'm gonna need to buy a tedder. I can never figure out what I'm gonna do with each farm, like what I'm gonna do with her. Pure farming, I got a million games saved of, okay, I'm gonna do just fields, I'm gonna do just animals, just orchards on each save game, and or just start out with as much money and do everything, and yada yada. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do on this map, whether I'm gonna do animals and everything, but sheep can just do grass, so I'd be fine with the stuff I got right now. Or actually, no, that's right. No, do I have a loader wagon? No, I need a loader wagon, because that's easier than using the mixer wagon for the, just should be able to just dump the grass on them. So I wouldn't need the tedder for the hay. But then I couldn't do, like, cows. Because I do need hay. If I do pigs, I'm going to need to have another field or portion of one of my fields to do other things, because right now there's wheat and barley growing, I think, so at least one of the fields I could change, so one could be like, stay the crop and one could change into corn or something, but then I either need another field or portion off one to do the canola, sunflower, soybeans. And another one for potatoes, maybe. On my other map, then I'm just doing pigs. I don't even have potatoes. But, yeah, so. Depends on what I plan on doing. I may need a tedder to turn into hay. Definitely need a, or I'm going to need a, why do I even have this baler if I'm going to do, just sheep, I don't even need the baler, but if I'm going to do cows too, then I'm going to need the baler. That's why I kept it so far. Same thing with this thing. May or may not keep that. Might end up selling those. Maybe I'll just do sheep. Because all I need is grass, and that's easy, but I'll have to go back to the farm because I'm confused as to which map I'm on. I might have already put a water tower in and filled the cow's water. And we need the load. Actually, no, we need the loader wagon to make straw anyway, so. Or one of those thingies. It's much less equipment with the loader wagon, so. Maybe I shouldn't have brought the baler up here. I probably did because I planned on buying a trailer and eventually having cows. So I change my mind all the time, man. If the cows are going to be, the cows are right on your farm. I'm so also always so confused. The sheep just need grass, so I got the grass fields for them. Alright, so I don't need to worry about this. So now the baler, I can use the baler for starting to get ready for the cows, but I thought I had, keep on getting confused which map I'm on, so I have to buy a loader wagon for the straw also. Maybe I'll bale half this field. Use the rest for, get a loader wagon, use the rest for straw and for picking up the grass, because it's going to be a lot easier than trying to bale the grass. But I'll need to do that eventually for the cows, but we'll try, probably, I think I'm talking too damn much, but I think I'll start off with sheep again on this map, so all I need is a loader wagon to pick up the grass. I already got the baler down here, so I'll start doing most of this field or some of this field with bales to start for the feeding the cows, but maybe I should just sell it and the sprayer and get a loaded wagon so I can get straw for everybody. All the animals. Or the sheep don't need straw. But then I guess straw for the other ones. Because I don't think you can just dump a bale over, call it a day. I'm not sure if you can. That'd be kind of neat if you can just throw a bale over the fence. Anyway, I'm talking way too damn much. No one probably watches these videos, or very few people watch these videos anyway, or at least, I don't know if I've recorded any with Farming Simulator yet, so, we shall see. Thank you for watching. If you're watching, I do have a YouTube channel. I'm not famous, though, but there is a bunch of videos on there, mostly pure farming and a couple of Gran Turismo Sport videos or miscellaneous other video game or videos of my own cars or cheap cars or scooters. I think I'm just Ryan Murray on there. Subscribe, like, make me famous. Maybe not famous, but